the honey flow has begun. In the spring, it's usually pretty dramatic. But for me, part of beekeeping is learning everything bee adjacent. And so if you're in Texas, you may know one of the first major flows is Yaupon. So if you're central or east Texas, Yaupon holly is going to be one of your first major flows. And so I find myself learning more and more plants, keeping an eye on things. And so usually I know when something is close to blooming. Like this year, I was watching the elm trees, as I do most years. And they bloom about the third week of January here. But if looking in your hives and outside your hives, even the way to know you're on a honey flow, you're going to have a whole lot of activity. It's going to sound like an airport because they're coming in loaded with nectar. So they're heavy bees coming into land. They may have some congestion at the entrance because there's so many foragers going out if you've got a real populous hive. When you look in that hive, you're going to probably have they're going to be doing what's called whitening comb. And what that is they're making wax. They're kind of stimulated to make wax. And so around the edges of things, there's going to be bright white new wax. That's a really good sign. And then honestly, as you're lifting through it, if they've been putting it up a little while, you'll know it's heavy. But right at the first, you know, you may just have a whole lot of frames that have that, you know, shine of nectar in the cells. As a flow goes on, so like a really heavy, like a tallow flow, they may even start cramming that nectar into cells you don't want them to, kind of in the brood nest. So that's another sign. Spring usually comes on, you know, hard, heavy. and then that kind of slows down. So we've got several plants that are really heavy producers, and then little plants in the middle that are decent producers. And then summer kind of dries off, and then we get to fall. And most of the time we get decent honey in the fall. It depends. Depends on where you are. If you're in a good goldenrod area, that's great. Actually, the hill country does fairly well in the fall to me, surprisingly well. In the fall, they may not be stimulated quite to that same extent as they are in the spring. So you might not see them whitening a lot of comb. You might not see that, but you are probably going to notice just weight-wise. So the fall is when I'm going, especially later in the fall, to go check weight. And by weight, I mean honey and nectar, because that's the heavy stuff. And so, you know, you take that super off and all of a sudden it weighs 20 pounds. And that's the fall flow. And it'll creep up on you. They can sometimes put up quite a bit of honey. And if not, you're feeding. So that's when I'm noticing, is when I'm checking for weight anyway. And I'm saying either the plants will do it or I will do it in the fall. But it's a little more gradual than the spring.